In 1868, the Hudson's Bay Company had agreed to relinquish title to its vast landholdings in the Northwest, but the transfer to the Crown and to Canada was not yet legally concluded. Prime Minister MacDonald looked forward to the day so he could further his plans for a railroad and for Confederation. The native people in the territory, Indians and Métis, saw only an impending danger to their freedom to hunt and to live. In that same year, a young Métis returned from the East to the Red River territory of his birth, Louis Riel.
The great wild west show that you've heard about, talked about, and read about. The battles, the burnings, the dreamings, the schemings, the entertaining and exciting historical and emotional pageant that brought about this very country we love, this land we call our own. You will see them all, the most notorious, the most amazing Little Annie Oakley, the dangerous Sitting Bull, and Gabriel Dumont.
Hey, Mr. Dumont, let's see you hit this.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The fearsome Métis general whose band of Indians set the great Northwest aflame with feats of marksmanship and military strategy the world may never see again. My friends, direct from Staten
Dumont,
Island.
I came all the way from Toronto to get a story, and for 2 days...
Hey, I just gave you all you're going to get.
Now go home. You think nobody cares, but they do. My newspaper cares, and the least you can do is answer a few
questions. Hey, go ask the Prime Minister. Go ask the railroad. Go ask the jury. They got no more questions.
I have.
Ask me a question I haven't heard before.
Why'd you lose?
Who says we lost?
What are you doing here?
They say you still talk to him.
They say. He's dead.
Do you?
Crazy?
Maybe you think we was crazy, too?
Some people think so. Was he?
Would it make any difference? If he was right?
I was at the trial.
Do you know what Metis is?
I think so, yes. Person of mixed blood.
A half-breed. Indian from his mama and French from his papa. The big winners, huh? From both of them, proud. Very proud.
Riel.
Oui. Maybe God knew what I needed and put Louis Riel there just at the right time.
Thank you. You remember me? Elzean. Gabriel, is that some Canadian stealing our food? Is Metis, my best friend when we were young.
MacDougall. He's on his way up, Sir John.
Now, Donald, don't lose your perspective. He arranged for the company to sell us the territory. And if he thinks being governor out there is his just reward, who are we to disagree?
Take care, my friend, that you see more than just the missing link to the West.
Donald, if it was anything more than flat plains that can boil the Indians in the summer and freeze them in the winter, do you think the Bay Company would agree to give it up? You know how the company thinks. For God's sake, man, you are the head of it.
It is a third of a million square miles of prime real estate.
It is Confederation for Canada. And I mean to have it.
Oh, you will have it, Sir John. But it is quite another thing to hold it. The French half-breeds don't understand the English. The English ignore the French. And the Americans have been eyeing all of it.
Well, the Americans eye everything that isn't nailed down. Are you saying I need a stronger man out there? A man who can nail things down?
Could be.
Oh, priorities, my friend, priorities. I need you to finish financing the railway that will tie this country together. After that, we can talk about your sugar plum dreams for that prime real estate.
Twelve years. It seems a long time to be away. You're a priest now?
I left the seminary to study law. I'm not a lawyer either.
You went to school to learn?
To learn of God.
God is life. That must be lived, not studied.
Why did you come back?
My father died.
First Hudson's Bay, then the Canadians. Taking this land and selling it all to each other.
Riel, what would you do?
The Métis are a nation. They should deal the way nations deal with each other. The way they understand. By petition, in writing.
Writing is for women.
And for men.
This.
Canadians. They tell us to give up the buffalo and farm the land. The buffalo, they feed us. We believe that we belong to the land. And you destroy the land if you dig in it.
If Canadians have a piece of paper that says they own the land, it would have to be written by God himself.
What do you say to that?
My respects to the great Metis leader. How can you know what God writes or what Canadians think? You can't read.
Maxim, get some grease.
God, Louis, you got to be crazy.
I told your friend before he left of my desire that he stay in close touch. Were you able to convince him of how important I believe he can be?
Louis is Louis, Your Grace. It's hard to convince him of anything. But when he'd run out of breath after trying to revive an old argument of ours from seminary days, I gave him your message. He understands.
The church is the key to preservation of French culture in these turbulent days. He must not forget that. I worry about the influence of his Quebec lawyer friends who may think otherwise.
Louis hasn't changed, Your Grace. Despite that temper, that pride, he is still a man of deep religion.
Deep enough to respond to his people, our people. If MacDonald pursues this Protestant confederation...
I know nothing of politics, Your Grace.
I know politics, McWilliams. I'm asking you if you know men.
Yours. Deeded to Elizabeth Schultz, witnessed by Tom Scott. From the river to the main road.
They won't go back on their word?
Put markers out. They already think those stakes are powerful religious symbols. They don't mess with that.
I appreciate this, Tom.
Do you? When does the doctor get back?
He won't be back from Ottawa for a few more weeks.
My friends are asking me about deeds to the land they farm, Mr. McTavish. Or the land on which they live between buffalo hunts.
The buffalo are disappearing. But, of course, nobody knows that better than the Métis, eh?
What about the land rights?
Top of the list for the new governor when he takes over next month. Oh, Mrs. Schultz. Excuse me. Well, Mrs. Schultz, what do you hear from the good doctor?
Well, he writes me that the new governor is fond of champagne. I'll need enough for 200 people for the reception. We've already printed newspaper announcements.
Oh, see, now, here's an item for the Norwestern. Young Louis Riel here is back from Montreal for a visit.
Yes? Well, the only ones interested in that don't read. I'm sure you're happy to be back. In the middle of the month.
Aye. Good day, Mrs. Schultz. Nice woman, really.
Why would a nice woman sell liquor to Indians?
Oh, now, you're mistaken, lad.
Am I? You're the law. Find out.
The company's closing down here. I don't have authority anymore.
Who does? The Canadians? They can't govern until they're here.
Well, I suppose you might say that just for now, we don't belong to anybody. Not that it matters, of course.
Canadian followed by the newspaper. You read it?
Did you? The wise and prudent will be prepared to receive and benefit by the changes to be made when Canada assumes sovereignty, whilst the indolent and careless, like the native tribes of the country, will fall back before the march of superior intelligence.
You still think you fight fire with paper?
You fight paper with paper and fire with fire. For now, the Canadians fight with paper.
Your father was an example to follow, Louis.
Always he looked for the truth. Always a good friend. Stubborn, though. He tried to fight the company, so they cut him off. And after that, well, they didn't understand him. Well, they still don't understand us. And I don't understand them. I only know there are more and more of them here every day.
Get out of here!
Boy, this is government business. Good for you. Road right past your farm.
No! You're building in the middle of our farm!
Don't you be foolish, boy.
Maybe he knows we're jumping the gun, Tom. Maybe we should get the hell out of here quickly.
Let go!
No half-breed's gonna be rude to me. You need a lesson in manners, boy.
God sakes, Tommy, he's just a kid.
You want a piece of it, Mayor?
Then you get the hell out!
No! No!
All right, that's it. He's not getting up. Let's get out of here.
He won't forget that for a while.
You're damn right. None of us will.
Get rid of it, Mayor. Well, well.
You don't belong here.
That's right. We want a road built here, we'll build it ourselves.
Not anymore. Now the road goes where the government wants it.
That to your government.
Charles Nolan, now you're a Métis with a lot of friends in the Canada Firsters. You ought to know better than this. This road is government business. You know better than to interfere with that.
It's not what you are doing that matters. It's that you've got no right to do anything here. Your government isn't in power yet.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means that you're a liar.
Now listen! This land is all going to Canada, and all of you will be looked after.
Like this?
I want you to move that chain 50 yards due west.
I said move it!
Maybe we shouldn't.
Get the hell off that chain!
Do what we've got to do now.
Everyone listen. It's a matter of justice. The many promises were made to us for coming out to open this area when no other settlers were willing. So what I am proposing tonight is a suggestion to Governor McDougall that will assure that those promises to us will not be jeopardized.
Riel.
for coming to him.
Gabriel has something to say to you.
I have a letter I want you to write.
Gabriel means he needs you to help him compose the letter as well as write it.
The Canadians are sending their governor in early.
You sure?
The servant, one of us, overheard.
If they try to enter the territory before all the papers are signed, it's illegal, of course.
Of course. And we must respond. But in legal terms.
That's what Gabriel has in mind. Eh, Gabriel?
We can do without him.
Gabriel. It doesn't diminish you as Metis leader to acknowledge that in these matters he knows more than any of us.
Louis.
Do not beg!
All of you here are a mixture of two bloods, Indian and French. And from that mixture has come the greatness of the Métis. Well, I propose a similar mixture. Together, the two of you could be God's answer to our needs. But like the Métis, you must act like one being. You, the head, Louis. And you, Gabriel. The heart. I have no more to say. Louis. Will you consider it?
I'll consider it. I mean paper. I need pens. And I need men.
Get him pens! Get him paper! I will get your men!
Dated at Red River, this 21st day of October, 1869. Sir, We, the newly formed National Committee of the Metis of Red River, order William McDougall
not to enter the territory of the Northwest without special permission of the above-mentioned committee. By order of Louis Riel. What the hell are you getting me into?
They have no right to stop you, sir.
Perhaps we'd better wait until my commission is actually legal.
They're bluffing. Early or late, they wouldn't dare stop the governor.
Move out of the blasted way! From the Prime Minister of Canada. Will you stop that? Now!
Delicate and gentle woman and my friends are now being virtually held captive by these hooligans.
An unfortunate situation, Dr. Schultz.
Unfortunate? It's a dangerous and demeaning situation. Now, what action does our government intend to take to protect them?
The natives don't harm their captives, Doctor. It's not part of their culture.
Now, what about Louis Riel? He's civilized.
That could make him dangerous.
When we were encouraged to settle in the territory, we assumed certain guarantees.
Sir John.
Oh, yes. I've read the dispatch. Poor McDougal.
Who is this, Riel?
And, more important, can he be dealt with?
He's a Métis, but educated in Quebec. A protégé, I understand, of Bishop Bourget.
Oh, one of those. Well, you know the territory and the natives. How serious is it? Troops?
If you send them west, you'd best reserve a battalion to quiet Montreal.
Oh, he sounds more than a protégé.
Well done, Donald. I believe you're a natural.
He's controllable, Sir John. He's primarily concerned about land rights.
Aren't we all? No. Troops would be a very bad political move.
Quite uncalled for at this point.
And what is called for, then?
Well, as you said, I know these people.
How long?
Not long.
I still dream of our railroad.
It will not reach the Pacific until the West is secure.
I'll be quick, Donald. Pour a little oil on troubled waters, and then knock Dumont and Riel right out of Fort Garry. And be quick.
Mm-hmm.
Do you mind? No.
Oh, we need another chair.
What's all this?
There's no question about it. We're in excellent position.
Of course. Oh, here it is. The logical precedent to support the condition under which we propose to join Canada.
Oui. You did very well. But now you take all your books and you go home.
Say to Smith?
Same as I told you. Thank you. And go home.
And then they'll send their army.
And we fight them.
So they'll send a bigger army.
And we fight them again. And we beat them. Again and again and again.
And each time, as you bind a wounded, comfort the widows, you will search the plain for more buffaloes, more Metis hunters. With both will have been scattered like dry leaves in the wind. The head and the heart, Gabriel.
I want our people to have a place where they belong. And nobody can look down on them or tell them how to live.
But I believe we can have that without paying with Metis blood.
I promise you the Metis will live here in freedom and dignity. I won't stop until it is done. I can be very determined, you know.
Son of a bitch. And I may be another.
Today, the Council of the Northwest has formally declared a provisional government to investigate and protect the rights of the people of this settlement. It is now the only authority in the territory.
Bloody treason!
That's right. On the contrary, Mr. Scott, according to the law of nations, our position is legal. I hold myself ready to conclude arrangements with the Canadian government if I judge them favorable to us all, Indians, French, English, and Métis. Yeah! All of us.
You'll try to keep Canadians out.
That's right. Why should we? We Metis know what it is to be looked on as second class. Why should we believe Canadians will like it any better than we do? There is enough land here for all of us, and no need to fight over it.
Who the hell picked you to tell us what to do?
Come and pray with me, Mr. Scott, and you can ask God that question. I've been elected by this council as Secretary General. Yeah. Father Richaud is already on his way to Ottawa with our demands to the Prime Minister.
Demands?
Title to our own land, full province status, money for schools.
What will you teach? French? Cree?
What if Canada tries to enter the territory?
That would constitute an invasion, Mrs. Schultz. I would have to take up arms to repel it.
My dear, we don't have to listen to this.
It's treason. Treason. We'll have us all dead at our beds if we stay with him. We've got to send our own representation to the government. Treason will have us all dead.
Do you think you can reason with these half-breeds?
They will listen, Gabriel. Gabriel. He's got everybody upstairs scared to death. There's nothing we all can talk till hell freezes over. I say kill them all.
Come on, stack. Now!
Back.
Well?
He's stubborn.
He's a dangerous savage.
He's a liar.
He's a politician, Gabriel.
That's exactly what I said.
He must agree to honor the promises that brought us here.
My dear Mrs. Schultz, he must first agree to become part of Canada. If he decides to make his provisional government permanent, and he can, legally, we are all finished here.
Some of us favor other ways of dealing with him.
nomi Patris, et Filii, et Spiritui Sancti. Amen.
Get the cannon! Aim in that door! Lower it!
Are you all right, Louis?
Hey, you're inside! Are you so fearful that you can't stand the test of your own laws? Or that none of you will treat us as equals?
You have 1 minute to come out, or you'll be blown out! You hear me? This is Dumont! You have 1 minute! Seconds!
I want no one hurt.
If anybody moves, I'll kill him.
The troops and Scott.
Put them under arrest.
If you please, Mr. Schmidt.
Him too.
The Prime Minister, Your Grace. Ah, Bishop Bourget.
How clever of you to find Father Richaud. I was about to have our police instigate one of their famous searches. You disappeared into the air.
I developed a chill in Ottawa, Prime Minister. Monseigneur felt that Montreal might improve my condition.
Close the door and sit with us, Father. Father McWilliams is an old friend of Louis Riel from seminary days.
Ah.
You are here to discuss Riel. Yes. He's a fascinating man. Fascinating. He has vision, determination. He cares for his people and has their trust.
Oh, how he has their trust. Like us in our younger days, eh?
Time only makes us longer of tooth and more impatient. The vision and determination remain unchanged. My vision is of a single country that stretches from ocean to ocean, strong, self-sufficient, and influential in the world.
Riel shares that vision, sir.
So do we all. At issue, it seems, is the price to be paid for this vision.
No price is too great.
There are those who don't share that theory, Sir John. not only the Métis in the West, but your French countrymen here in Quebec.
The thoughts of all our people, Bishop, are constantly on my mind. I'm sure that by the time Donald Smith returns from meeting with Riel, you'll find the air in Ottawa very much warmer.
I shall be in touch, Father Richaud, rest assured. Gentlemen.
You can't keep these people here.
They choose to act like criminals. We respect the choice and treat them accordingly.
And then what?
They choose to believe we're savages. So maybe we'll scalp them. Or better yet, put on war paint and burn them at the stake.
For God's sake, Riel, you're being unreasonable.
For God's sakes, I'm far too reasonable. You believe we are children requiring your benevolence to organize a government. If you persist in that belief, then you and your friends here are all fools.
Release me and let me present the facts to the Prime Minister.
Father Richaud has tried and has been ignored.
I can change that.
Look at your friends, Mr. Smith. And look at us. Are we any less entitled to our homes, our dignity, our way of life? Are we any less human, Mr. Smith? In your eyes, or God's?
I can change that. I promise you.
You'll leave tonight. I'll release the others after that.
Thank you.
Do not let the Prime Minister mistake our compassion for weakness. We will have our way, Mr. Smith.
Bloody miserable. They're going with you. Make sure that son of a bitch pays for this.
Where's Scott?
We spread up. He's probably across the border by now.
Get up!
Church at dawn?
Every morning.
I missed him the first time. This time I won't.
Métis law. The law of the hunt. Our people understand that. Any other way...
No. Scott expects that. We must use Canadian justice, trial by jury. We must show them we understand their system.
Oh, We cannot just knock Dumont and Riel out of Fort Garry.
No, nor can we simply give in. Oh, Donovan. Why are the easy things always so difficult to
manage? There's not a damn thing he wants that you wouldn't offer him anyway.
Give him a way to fit into Confederation that he can live with. And you have the railroad and the West. He still wants to be part of Canada, Sir John.
How we understand it, then. This man, Tom Scott, is guilty of going against our government here. The English word for that is treason. What I know about their law, the people guilty of treason, we got to execute them.
Thomas Scott, you have been found guilty of treason, and you will be executed according to your laws. May God have mercy upon your spirit.
You are all bloody insane, do you hear me? You stupid savages. I'm a British subject.
Once more, your sense of timing is inappropriate, Mrs. Schultz.
So is yours, Mr. Riel. May I at least be invited in? That wasn't the way I'd hoped this conversation would begin. You're still convinced that we don't understand you. I think you don't understand us.
I understand why you're here, Mrs. Schultz.
Us, Mr. Riel, the English. And if you think that killing Scott will frighten us into kneeling to your demands, you do not understand the English.
I understand English law.
You do not understand English justice. You proved your point when you found him guilty. You only prove ours. If you insist on execution.
I must go. You should stay here.
No, I must go.
Who would send a man onto the plains alone? No horse, no gun. And if God wants him to survive, he will survive. But if you don't know the Metis, how can you know the Metis law?
I can't come.
Murder!
Ready! What is this matter?
Full blood and murder! You son of a bitch!
So trespasses will forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. I forgive you, Thomas Scott, for all your sins. And we will meet again. In heaven, where our Holy Father will make us one.
Commend your soul to the Almighty God.
You may tell Mr. Riel that, as he wishes, this new province shall be called Manitoba. And that a new governor shall be sent out there come the spring. Provincial elections will take place at that time. I hope this measure will receive the acceptance of the people of the Northwest.
There is the question of amnesty.
We will not be legally prosecuting any members of the provisional government. Well, thank you for being here. And my regards to the bishop.
You're very efficient at this sort of thing. You, too, are very efficient at your sort of theater, I'm told.
Schultz.
He's in the middle of it.
Ten people can represent 10,000 votes.
To the railway!
Donald, you're blessed by being a businessman. Your life is guided by a single factor. Money. Bourget is blessed. His life is guided by two factors. The church and the French language. I'm cursed. By being a politician. A businessman is immune to love. A bishop can inherit it with his mantle. But a politician... A politician is always... He's forever seeking it from his people. Trying to do what he believes is right. And trusting that the factions which he governs will understand. My whole life is plagued with factions, with symbols. I mean, Tom Scott and Louis Riel have already become symbols. The English Protestant, the French Catholic. Symbols! The span of a man's life, Donald, is brief. But symbols? Have a way of living for a very long time.
Manitoba!
Size we're taking off. It's just some buffalo. I still lead the hunt.
Build a basket of here.
Some of the men going home, planting crops.
Metis are not farmers.
If there are no buffalo, they may have to learn.
When do you come back?
when you need me. When you need to learn more things from me. About people. That's what I'm here. Yes, sir. As you suggested, I'm referring to it as a peacekeeping mission.
Well, there'll be a new governor following you out there. And you'll be leaving at the end of the week.
Yes, sir.
4.25 cents, a 1/4 of a dollar, ladies and gentlemen.
When did he tell us we had a province named Manitoba? Everything we asked for. Next thing you know, the troopers come.
Peacekeeping?
Good name for it. As the old show wanted a piece of Louis Riel. It took them 96 days to get out from Ottawa. Wasn't any governor with them. Goulet got word from the Indians and warned Louis that the soldiers were out for his scalp. We didn't have to ask God for advice. He got the hell out of there just in time. Old General Woolsey made 3 mistakes. First, he let Louis get away. Second, he and his mercenaries thought they could make the Metis tell where Louis was. The fools. The only ones who knew were me and my men, and we were already on our way to him. And third, Woolsey figured it was all over so easy, so quick. Why should he delay an election in Manitoba? Who could make trouble?
Bishop Bourget would not approve.
Bishop Bourget is not here.
The bishop is concerned for your safety. He thinks you should go to the United States until things are quiet. He sent me that message, along with some money for you.
I'm grateful for his concern and his money. Of course, I must stay. There's no other way.
Louis, you don't seem to understand.
I understand there is no amnesty. I understand we are hunted and beaten. I understand they are burning our farms. And I understand the only place to right this grievance, once and for all, is in the Canadian Parliament, face to face with the Prime Minister.
You are defying the Church.
I defy the Church? How could I, Father? It guides my every thought.
How are we in the north, Maxime?
All right.
Has somebody gone to the Falcon people? No. Gabriel, we must get to everyone.
Riding. Oh, come in, sir.
Two
We'll rest on the other side.
I know Louis. He'll take his place in Parliament.
And I know Parliament. He will chew him up and spit him out.
I'm certain he can explain the Scott affair.
Father McWilliams, listen carefully. The country doesn't want an explanation, not now. Scott's death gives substance to the anti-French and anti-Catholic forces as long as it remains unexplained.
Bodies here.
They can do anything now. I'm officially registered.
We'll write that on your tombstone. Come on. We'll do this my way. Don't run.
You idiot. How could you let him do it? How could you let him just walk in and sign?
We are getting out of here.
I'm not afraid of them.
Excuse me, sir. Is there a way to the front door? We make one turn and two turns and we are lost.
Well, it's along the hall and down the stairs.
You mean this way?
No. Here, let me show you. Where did you say you were from?
Manitoba, sir.
You go home to Manitoba and live happily and prosperously ever after. That was the promise we made to you and your wife, wasn't it?
I want Riel dealt with.
I said go home, Doctor. You attend to your affairs, I'll attend to mine.
They have revoked your seat.
You once told me you have a great love for our people.
And I do.
Then help me.
I am. Louis, for your sake, listen to reason.
I have been lied to. Used. Betrayed. I have watched my oldest friend die in my arms.
I am called criminal and pursued by men who would feel fully justified in killing me. Where is reason?
There must be a way to get through to these people. To get what I promised, Metis. I will find that way.
We cannot leave here like this.
Agnus Dei, qui colus, peccata mundi.
Is it in all this?
Agnus Dei.
Rise up, Louis Riel. Through you, all the children of the world shall be blessed.
Louis, well, listen to this. You've been at this 18 hours.
Listen to it. Will be a place where all the oppressed people of the world can come and live in safety. A haven. Jews, Poles, Russians. You see, there's a broader purpose to all of this than I ever realized. We must invite them. People who are suffering. They are the one who has settled the West. People like the Metis who will love the land, who won't just take from it, but who will give as well. And it is God's plan. The one he meant for me to deliver everywhere. Stephen, you must see what I'm planning.
Louis, there's no time. You've got to leave now. From Ottawa. You've been officially exiled from the country.
How dare you bring such a paper? How dare you? Bring it back where you came from and leave me alone! I've got work to do! God's work, you understand now? Leave me alone!
Louis!
Oh my God!
This is Long Point Asylum, and I am Dr. Juan. Your friends thought that your life might be in danger, and this is a perfect place to hide.
An asylum? Oh, the priest I hit. Is he all right?
Yes.
Foolish bit of anger. How will you forgive me?
Yes, you were quite disturbed.
I'm all right now. If you just please have my things returned, I'd like to leave.
Oh, but you've been admitted.
Admitted?
Under another name, naturally.
I have so much to do.
Yes, tell me about that. Tell me about the visions that you have.
I have a mission. Doctor.
What?
To go back to the West.
A holy mission.
I believe God directs me.
God
directs you, yes.
I heard the voice of God.
And that voice tells you you are a kind of savior to these people? A messiah?
I don't expect you to understand.
But I do, you see. Sometimes people who have visions, who hear voices...
What are you telling me?
I am saying that sometimes people who have visions, who hear voices, who put themselves into dangers, sometimes those people need help.
What have you given me?
Just a sedative that we use here to calm you, to begin helping you.
So we'll speak again in a few days. Please rest now.
When among you shall betray me? Is it you, Stephen?
Louis, you'll be all right here.
Gabriel. Is it Gabriel?
Believe me, Louis, we love you.
Bishop. I must talk to the bishop.
Your Grace, I know what would be of great comfort to him. Could you put it in a note? It would mean so much.
I suffer for Louis' mental language, but I'm not unhappy that at this particular time the church has spared his politics. If the country is to be torn over the issue of the West, I prefer the blame be laid where it belongs. Not at the door of a French Catholic, but of an English Protestant. Now, what did you want me to write? It is the best place for you now, but God will not abandon you in the hour of your need. Pray, and the Lord will bring to you an altered calm to see you through this period. A sign will come to you if you are patient.
Thank you for coming, Sir John.
No. Thank you. Thank you. It appears at the moment that the country is calm enough for me to accommodate you.
I'm counting on it. There is that matter of separate schools for those who prefer it in Manitoba.
Ah. Well, that would be up to the governor, Bishop. Education is a provincial matter.
A government representative suggested by you might be influential when the governor considers the question.
Something worth thinking about.
There is a Metis named Charles Nolin who would be eminently qualified and acceptable.
I see.
This rose bush is a favorite of mine. I planted it myself, but grew large and unruly, and it threatened the other flowers. I was distressed, but I had to cut it back. Now the garden is under control, but a little sunshine would help the smaller flowers somewhat, don't you think?
You may be right, Bishop.
Nolin. Charles Nolin. Sojourn.
there is a position for him in the United States, a settlement in Montana.
Highly unusual.
Would you rather that the bishop cut short more pressing matters to come and deal with this himself?
Released? On your authority?
His condition changed. His sanity returned.
Returned?
Miraculously. And his sense of purpose as well. It can only be attributed to your kind letter, Your Grace.
So Louis went to Montana, and he taught school and got married. He even became an American citizen.
So the Metis left Fort Garry.
No room for us. No schools for us. No work, no language. Nobody to argue for us. No Riel.
You moved to Saskatchewan.
That's what they call it now. Then, hell, it was just a place further west where we could start all over again. Batoche, we called it. And Charles Nolin was supposed to be our government representative. If he only took care of us like he took care of himself. If, lots of ifs. Government didn't have enough money for food or timber contracts. But they had money for Montes to see that we obeyed the law. A man called Crozier was in charge. Metis' eyes had lost their spark. They were beaten. They needed something, someone, a torch they still remembered and talked about.
The bones, eh? Which end? You got it. Your turn now. You want to try?
Marguerite is Metis. She understands what our people need. And living here, she knows the importance of a piece of land, the recognition of who you are, the freedom to live the way you want. She agrees to your coming back? Of course. We both knew it was only a matter of time, of God deciding the right place. We'd be starting all over again. Not quite. This time I have a plan. A plan for me, for our people, for all the oppressed people of the world. You'll come back with us? God wants you to know you have chosen the right way. Now. There are four of you, and you arrive on the 4th of June. You want a fifth to return with you? Then you'll wait until the 5th. Tomorrow, I'll give you my decision.
See you tomorrow.
See ya.
What did he say, Gabriel?
We kept talking about old times. I'll ask him tomorrow about going back.
Sir John,
The Privy Council was our last hope. The creditors, they demand payment. Otherwise, they'll seize the stock and equipment.
Oh, what other damn happy news have you got for me this morning?
Another petition from the West demanding redress from grievances. It's signed by Louis Riel. You remember him?
Let me see it.
Idle threats.
Good God. He's suggesting separation.
The creditors, Sir John.
It's Parliament that counts. When they know about these threats, it will drive them bloody mad.
Believe me, Yasiwin, it's not too late. The Crees and the Blackfoot are our brothers. Your mothers were our mothers. Join us, and we'll be strong again.
Good.
A little more time here and you'll walk as quiet as the creek.
Well, it's quiet so far, Gabriel. Maybe not as quiet as you and I might like, but at least it's quiet.
Major Crozier, you're a fair man. You know we cannot be still forever.
Some of your men have loose tongues and big imaginations. They've made a lot of people jumpy.
A lot of people had it pretty good before Louis came. Now they'd like to see him go.
Looks like they're gonna get their way. I have a signed order from the Prime Minister to arrest Riel unless he leaves.
On what grounds?
He's a threat to the security of the country.
Chloe, don't do this!
Roger is at Duck Lake with reinforcements.
Crozier won't back down.
Neither will I.
If I must, I'll use the church to stop you. Listen to me! You must not do this! The church is against it! All of you! Either we came in pride, or we crawled back to where we were! Now God rise with us!
Make sure we're covered over there.
Some of the men have personal feelings about these people. I suggest they keep those feelings out of what we do today. See if they'll talk.
What is this trouble, Major?
It won't start with us.
You know what to say?
Yes, Gabriel.
Okay, go on.
Thank you.
I came to speak for Pete.
There's no need for that. When he gives himself up, it'll all be over.
You have no jurisdiction over us. We've done nothing wrong. Neither has he.
Who told you to say that? You get Riel down here and see what he says.
We want to be left alone.
Well, there's no need for a gun, brother.
That's a gun, Pete.
God will protect us!
Steal you.
All right, fire away!
In the name of God, keep firing!
Don't you keep firing!
We're badly positioned, Major. They're all around us.
Fool. It all could have been so easy.
Damn that Dumont.
Form for retreat.
Go behind them! Rush!
Jim Al! I think they've killed Jim Al!
Kill them all of them! Courage! When the hell is in blast, we don't die!
Let us cheer the man who has given us this victory, Gabriel!
Well, what did they say?
They asked how serious it was.
You told them that in my judgment, we need at least 5,000 troops and equipment in the West as soon as possible.
I told them that in your judgment, yes.
But you?
I don't think it warrants.
The only way to accomplish this is to finish the railway, you know. How long to Batoche?
There are still great gaps. It only goes as far as Capel.
Canada will have its railway, Donald. Canada's at war.
The gentlemen of the press in this country realize it will not be an easy campaign.
All right.
Almighty mercy, I beseech you to spare the life of this man, my friend, who so nobly serves you. If our cause is just and right, I need him to do your will.
To the part where he names me Pope to preside over his new religion?
No, Your Grace, I'm still at the part where he's describing it, renaming the days of the week and the countries of the world. Polygamy. Saturday is to be the Lord's Day of Rest. Oh, yes, here it is. And Bishop Bouget...
I know what it says, Father.
It's as if Louis had all this bottled up inside for years and then... it all suddenly exploded. Before he went to Montana, his visions, his...
My concern for him is deep, Father. But my concern for all French Catholics is deeper. Here in Quebec, we will draw closer, more protective of each other, more isolated from the rest of Canada. But in the West, our gains could be in great jeopardy.
He took it from the church. He says the prophet, the Messiah, needs something special for the altar.
What do you say?
I say I should dynamite the railway.
Do you have doubts, Gabriel?
About what? What we're fighting for? Hell no! Forgive me, Louis. I know my words offend you sometimes.
No, I mean doubts about me, what I am, what I do for God's people.
I believe that God wants us to be as we are. Strong like the Indian, crazy like the French, and free to roam like the buffalo in a land that belongs to no man but to all men.
And I believe I am God's instrument to bring this about. Starting here in Batoche. Even if we have to fight with our lives. Louis.
Are you sure that God or his prophet, Louis Riel, don't want me to blow up the railway?
Okay, let's move it out. Be very careful.
The American Howard is ready for the demonstration, sir.
Oh, yes, by all means. Anything to break the monotony.
Accelerate! Cut!
I've told my wife I expect to be home shortly. Now, is there anywhere in this colony to post this letter so that it gets there before I do?
Things are a bit rustic in these parts, sir.
Really? So this is it.
Gentlemen, you see before you the product of the most advanced techniques of American science and industry, invented by Dr. R.J. Gatling, capable of discharging 1,200 bullets in 1 minute.
You are rather blocking our view, Mr. Howard.
Oh, sorry. General, I would like to make its first real test in your campaign against the rebels. Would you like to try it?
No. It's your machine, Mr. Howard.
Sir Bradford! Sir! Clear the sight lines.
Yes, sir. Clear the sight line. Get those crates off the platform there. You men at the end, move up here quickly.
Thank you.
Hear me, my brothers. The Canadian troops are 10 miles away at Fish Creek. They come here to challenge us as a nation. Are we a nation?
We are!
Well, Metis, take up arms to protect their nation if it is invaded.
We are!
For God's sake! We fight for what is ours and for what God wants us to be.
Listen. Listen, everyone. This is not the way. Your priests, the church, all of us are opposed to this violence.
There is no church. Rome has fallen, and there are no priests. Only men who believe, and men who are enemies. And this man is an enemy. Arrest him. Arrest this man.
Lloyd is mad.
Never ever say that again. You hear me? Not to anyone. Arrest him, and be quick about it. We have some fresh Canadian buffalo to hunt at Fish Creek. For God, for Louis David Riel, and for the Métis Nation.
I wanted you to know, Mr. Prime Minister, that some of us are Canadians and Métis and find no conflict in being both.
Well, you reassure us, Mr. Nolan.
There are some claims, though, some letters that are still unanswered. The people involved... We are loyal Canadians in a hostile place. Any help would be...
Yes, well, thank you, Mr. Nolan, for sharing your first-hand report on the territory and your helpful insight into Riel.
Second thoughts about sending Middleton and the troops, Sir John?
What? Oh, no, 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 of course not. And Nola is an opportunist. He smells a chance to feather his own nest. I'm a pretty damn good one, too. I've used this to move the railway further west. But discounting all that, everything I hear convinces me that we could have talked till doomsday with Riel and still have got nowhere.
I dare say you're
Riel not... came back here meaning to have a fight, and by God, we're going to give it to him. Anything less than that, we might as well fold up the country and parcel it out to whoever will take it. Oh, no. What I did was right. I'm sure of it.
Something's bothering you.
Well, there's not a snowball's chance in hell that those people could divide the country from what it's meant to be. You know it, and I know it. Only they don't know it. Because every time Louis Riel tells them that night is day and black is white, they believe him. And they'll fight like hell to prove he's right. Impossible son of a bitch. I only wish he was one of us.
How are they holding up?
The Canadians, sir. Volunteers.
Oh.
Quite like our troops.
That's the fastest way to Batoche. We'll stop and rest in an hour and move on in two battalions.
Divide the troops, sir?
It's the best way of taking the village, you see.
Just thinking about the Indians and Custer.
Custer? Who?
Thank you.
Get down there, get down.
Your prayers made it happen.
Company A, 8 dead, 41 wounded. Company B, 5 dead, 16 wounded. Company C, 12 dead.
Will?
My best estimate, sir, is that there couldn't be more than 100 of them.
That's ridiculous. Tell them we underrated these natives. There was a large number, perhaps 500.
Yes, sir.
They dug trenches all over the place. It was impossible to see them.
They knew the hills, sir. Our men didn't have
Where are you from, Captain?
Ontario, sir?
Yes. Well, you tell your green Ontario troops that some professional English officers will lead them to Batoche, whether they're ready or not. We will meet with this devil, Louis Riel, and we will beat the hell out of these savages, with the Canadians or without. Do you understand me, Captain?
Sir.
No, the trench must end that way, up towards the church.
Aye.
And be sure it is deep enough.
Aye. Gabriel, you are a practical man. When you are hungry, you eat. When it rains, you look for cover. When the enemy comes, do you pray or do you fight?
This is where we have chosen to take our stand.
But you have seen how many there are of them. You have seen their guns. This is not our way to fight. We have no chance here.
Then you better pray before you fight.
Is that all you could find?
They're looking for more, but Gabriel, there's not much metal.
Excuse me, Father. My apologies, Father. Now we'll have some bullets.
They start to move.
There's the elevation and windage controls,
yes,
which are here and here.
It is ready to fire, though, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
He is good.
Okay.
9 pounders in position, sir.
Prepare to fire.
Prepare to fire!
Prepare to fire! Prepare to fire!
No sign of anybody at the moment. But you can never be too careful. Fire.
Fire! In succession from the right! Fire!
We'll have the infantry prepare to advance. Have them stand by.
Infantry, stand by! Hut! Hut, head! Hut!
Shoulder!
Charge! Arm!
Be sure the NCOs understand that this is a standard advance. We'll be covering ourselves at all times. Wait for my signal.
Sir.
Quick march!
Take a look.
Just fire the bloody thing, will you?
That's the bloody church, you fool!
The show is still inside!
Read from here!
Something!
Come for you! Get the show out of the church! Captain! Cease fire!
God, have mercy on your soul.
Let him go. Let him go.
Cease fire! Cease fire!
Thank you.
They don't know what they're doing.
Bad, sir. We have to pull back.
Backwards, damn it!
Silence! Hold your line!
We've corrected our angle, General.
Begging your pardon, sir.
That looks like a bullet from a Snyder Enfield rifle.
They were taken from one of our men, sir.
I didn't know the half-breeds had Snyder Enfield.
They don't, sir. They're so short of ammunition, they're digging our bullets out of the ground and firing them back at us. One of the Canadian volunteers, a lieutenant, says he knows these people. He's been against them before. He believes that if we were to rush them, they'd fall apart.
Captain, I want to clean up this mess with as little loss of life as possible.
Sir, he said that...
Thank you, Captain. And now I'd like to finish my dinner in peace, if it's perfectly all right with you.
What did he say?
He'll do it his way.
Cree tribe should be here by now. Upon make her promise.
The sun. It's a good omen.
Well, then, gentlemen, when everybody is in position, there will be the order to commence firing. Then we will move systematically down into the village while covering ourselves. You officers on the ridges, let no man move until you receive my signal. Do you understand?
Sir.
Up. There will be no mistakes, gentlemen.
What the hell's the matter with him? Attack.
Right. On the right. Charge!
Thank you.
brothers!
We'll be victorious.
Fresh horses. We head due south, and in 2 days we are across the border and safe. There are soldiers all through the woods, shooting Metis on sight.
We,
you and God, talk to each other 24 hours a day. Let him catch his breath while you listen to me. They'll do if they capture you.
I know that if I run, I deprive all this of any meaning.
Okay. So we stay.
Well, yeah, my friend. I must make that last familiar walk myself. We'll see each other again.
We... I believe in you.
Well, that was the last time I saw him. After that, you know what happened.
I was at the trial.
I wasn't. We knew they'd skin me alive if I showed up. Besides, I knew what Louis would do. He once said he was like a looking glass. Those who hated what they saw, they would just be seeing themselves.
Of course you can make a case out of it, Osler. After all, you are the Minister of Justice.
Sir John, it is
difficult case in which to establish a charge. Charge is treason. I want him taken back to Regina. I want him tried. I expect him to be convicted.
He's an American citizen. He took out papers in Montana.
That didn't stop him leading a rebellion in Canada.
The French look on him as one of them. With an election coming, it could alienate Quebec.
You think I don't realize that? And if he goes free, it'll alienate the English. Either way, I tear the country apart. Why must every issue, federal, provincial, large, small, become a test of the very identity of this country, for God's sake? Let us hope the future will be spared from such a destructive spectacle. I do pray, you know, that one day we may mature.
Oh,
there he is.
There he is.
The prophet of Saskatchewan was the cry under which his poor dupes were supposed to rally. Now, gentlemen of the jury, you will be satisfied before this case is over that it is not a matter brought about by any wrongs on the part of these poor primitive peoples, as much as it is a matter brought about by the personal ambitions and colossal vanity of the man on trial.
Your Grace, I have engaged Monsieur Lemieux, Your Grace, as you requested. He's the best defense lawyer in all Quebec.
Riel must be saved.
Yes, Your Grace.
If they can extinguish a French voice in the wilderness, it will be snuffed out throughout the country. I once dreamt of a Catholic New France in the West. So did Riel once. Two dreamers, one foolish dream. Perhaps
gentlemen of the defense, how do you plead?
Your Honor, we plead not guilty by reason of insanity.
No! I will not permit this. These men are not from the West. They have no grasp at all of what happened. I have discussed this with them and...
Sit down, Mr. Riel. If you do not like the way your counsel is dealing with your case, you may dismiss them and find new counsel. Or you may conduct your defense yourself.
If he won't cooperate, he can't defend you.
There are things I must say.
The prosecution has sworn statements from the Métis pointing to you as the single driving force behind the rebellion. You must follow Lemieux's advice.
What a ridiculous choice. If I'm mad, I'm innocent. If I'm guilty, I die.
Remember our history lessons, Louis. Galileo was tried by the Pope for heresy. He chose to recant his theories, and he lived. And he's remembered for his genius.
And Sir Thomas More.
A man of great principle. But he chose to die, and that is what we remember. His death, not his life.
Oh,
Your Honor, throughout this trial, the defendant has been uncooperative and now is insisting on giving his own summation.
Mr. Riel, is this true?
It is, Your Honor.
And do you fully realize the possible consequences of disposing of the defense of these learned men?
I do, Your Honor.
Then proceed.
For many days now, I have observed this trial conducted in such a way that has neglected the true issues and left me no option. Understand, Father Richaud, I said that I took advantage of the ignorance of the Metis to make myself appear as a prophet to them. The Metis turned to me only because the Catholic Church watched them suffer, neglected by our government over many years, and told them only to wait and be patient. It is hard to be patient when night after night you go to bed with your belly aching from starvation and you watch your children die. Charles Nolin, the Métis representative, has twisted everything I've said to make it appear selfish and evil. He said that I'd conspired to return to Saskatchewan, seeking vengeance against the Canadian government for my exile. I was asked to return by the people of Batoche to try to convince the Canadian government to fulfill the promises it had made. A job Charles Nolin was supposed to do, but would not, for fear of jeopardizing his business contracts with the government. And the learned Dr. Roy, on this stand, he has called me a megalomaniac, stating that I have a recurring mental disorder that causes me to act as I have. It's easier for them to call me a madman or a devil than to face the truth. And that truth is, when a government, over many years, continually misunderstands and mistreats a part of its people, then it should not be surprised when those people speak out. And when a government turns a deaf ear to the pleas of those people who are asking no more than what is their right, that they be permitted to live as they wish, then that government shouldn't be surprised when those people rise up against it. The Métis are not birds of the air. We cannot live the way we once did, roaming the plains, following the buffalo. We need a place to light, a place to call our own, to belong, the right to maintain and develop our identity and culture. And this has been denied. Yes, Dr. Roy, I still believe I have a holy mission. I dream that we can create a place of God in this huge country. A place where the oppressed people of the world could come, people who need it, who would love it, and would live there in peace with themselves and with their God. Is that so different from what you believe? And yet, I stand before you today, not only asking of my life with asking you if this is the behavior of an irrational man. I have watched my people die. I have seen an entire way of life trampled by a new civilization they did not understand. And for a brief moment, I stood in the path of this civilization. This progress. Not to stop it, but rather to address a new government. A government far away in the East, which had no idea of who my people were or how they live. All I asked for was respect for the rights and the liberty and the dignity of the Metis. If this be madness, then I am mad. But I am in good company. If this be treason, then I am guilty. For in this, I will always believe.
Louis Riel, this court has found you guilty. And I only have one more duty to perform. It is to advise you to meet your end. It is the sentence of this court that you be taken from here to the police guardroom in Regina, and that you be kept there until the 18th of September next, whence you will be taken to the place appointed for your execution, and there be hanged by the neck until you are dead. And may God have mercy upon your soul.
Amen. Lord, forgive me by this holy anointing and this most loving mercy, whatever sins you have committed by the use of your mouth. Amen. May Lord forgive you by this holy anointing and this most loving mercy, whatever sins you have committed by the use of your hands. Amen.
A good day for a journey. I prayed for you, Charles. For you too, Father. Stephen.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. Amen.
I go next. Bang, bang. Give the public what they want, eh?
You've been very helpful.
No, I haven't. I didn't tell you whether he was a saint or sinner, mad or sane, right or wrong. Hey, why don't you come in and watch the show? Pretty damn good for 2 bits.
Mr. Dumont, the last time you saw him, you told him you believed in him.
Mister, I still believe in Riel.